The baseball jumped so fast off Dexter Fowler's bat, one wouldn't think it was catching a train heading out of downtown St. Louis. In a matter of seconds, a 3-2 Cubs lead turned into a 4-3 Cardinals win and sweep of the series. Things can change that fast in baseball, the home of crooked numbers, bittersweet endings. Confession, I fell asleep in the 11th inning. There's nothing like falling asleep during an extra inning Cardinals-Cubs game and waking up later that morning to a glorious Redbird walk-off. As a writer, it provides numerous possibilities, all of which having the ability to vanquish any Monday morning blues one may be having. As a fan, it's the best kind of morning coffee blend. While I sip La Coseca Coffee Roaster's delicious pour-over Ethiopia Hambella, allow me to provide 5 takeaways that we can pull from a 4-3 walk-off victory that placed the Cardinals among the best in the National League at 20-12. 5. Before I drool over Fowler's extra-inning abilities, I want to tip my head to the Cardinals' bullpen, which worked at a boss level over the weekend against the Cubs. There's no sweep without their 8.2 innings of one-run ball during Sunday's finale. Mike Mayer's got the win, shedding goat clothes for a pair of hero shoes after Fowler's winning blast. Overall, the pen offered 16.2 innings with only 5 runs touching home plate during that time. MVP of the series. 4. The Cardinals could have won the game sooner if they fared better with runners in scoring position. The Birds went 1-9 in that department, continuing a AL trend that should improve with more reps. The big hit HASNT completely eluded the Cardinals, only staying away until the last minute. 3. It may be a redundant thing here for the next few weeks, but Paul DeJong drew 3 walks last night. It may be the first time that has happened in his young burgeoning career, but either way, it's a feat due to the hitter's struggles with strikeouts. This is a coming attraction type allure here, because if DeJong can develop and sustain a better eye at the plate, he goes from slugger mode to all-star status. 2. If there's a reason Jed Gyorko should NT start every game for the Cardinals here this month, I'd love to hear it. The whole he plays too much and he'll be exposed theory is crap. Gyorko hits, can field, and does it at a number of spots for the Cardinals. He erased a quick 1-0 Cubs lead with his 3rd home run of the inning and added a double later. Play him, even at the expense of a more expensive player sitting. 0.1 Fowler produced a worrisome trend to start his 2018 and for the record, HES still hitting 0.161 on the. He was hitless before Monday morning came along with heroics. The 5 home runs and 16 RBI lessen the blow of Fowler's overall slash line, but he'll worry less about his start. After all, he has 3 game-winning hits, 2 of the walk-off variety during the past 10 days. He's got a flair for the dramatic, and during these early days of spring baseball, he'll take the end instead of the entire picture. Bonus takeaway, Colton Wong had 3 hits and started arguably the sweetest double play of the. If HES starting to came on, the lineup takes a more powerful shape. For the first time since the 2015, the Cardinals swept the Cubs. It's a big deal, because if you talk a big game like the Cardinals have this, the results needed to be there. The Pittsburgh turmoil is a figment of the imagination now, a past remnant that looks like ancient history now with a 5-game winning streak taking place. The Cardinals are 20-12 and near the top of the National League. A day after they saw their captain, the injured Yadier Molina, go down, the Cards responded with one of their biggest wins of the and their 5th walk-off victory of the year. Monday morning doesn't seem that bad right now. Copyright 2018 KSDK.